Next speaker, Sri Raghuram Krishnaraju.
The opportunity, Speaker sir, as for elderly learned Saugatraji. Oh, Saugatraji has mentioned. Oh, I'm sorry. After Meenakshi Lekhiji and so many eminent lawyers and person with abundant common sense, I'm speaking, but I'm in a way, I'm in between the most exposed person in the litigation, wherein I had filed many arbitration cases or arbitration cases were filed against the companies, so that I'm in a way, I'm an experienced person, so in that, in that sense I'll speak, and definitely I wholeheartedly support the welcoming step moved by the government of India by Honorable Minister. What? Yes, not conflict of interest, but I'm supporting. No, yeah, because I'm transparent. So it is a very welcoming step to have this international center of New Delhi International Center for Arbitration in lieu of the 1995 thing which has come under the Societies Act. It is already delayed, and I'm also supporting that many people were asking why this ordinance, it has already come to Lok Sabha and then it got stuck in Raj Sabha because of the sudden elections, and for a bill which is already delayed to come with an ordinance, it is nothing wrong, and I am supporting even that act of coming with an ordinance. And here what I wanted to specifically emphasize is, no, what I wanted to bring in is the time that is taking in the Indian arbitration system, which is taking years, it is not even months, it is taking years. Despite some amendments that has come in 2015 and 2017, there has been no change, and compared to our competitors, see Singapore and London, we are going to be their competitor, and there most of the proceedings, the initial proceedings, they were doing it by mail, and the actual proceedings they were finishing it in 5 days, compared to our 4 to 5 years which we were taking, they were doing it in 4 to 5 days, where entire proceedings they were able to complete, and the evidences, everything, they were able to complete it in 5 days. And our Honorable Minister has to take so many effective steps by getting eminent people and into the system, and wherein some eminent, not only the jurists, even some technically sound people also should be made part of this the new center, wherein all the disputes can be resolved in time, and it should also be cost effective, and we all know how much it is costing with the time delay. And Saugatraji has given an example of Reliance and something, and Tata Docomo, yeah, ONGC and Tata Docomo. So I need not get into those examples. I have my own example wherein GAIL had won an arbitration against GAIL, and they had preferred an appeal, and that is pending for the last 3 years. And so it's only as an example I'm telling, there is no self-conflicting interest or anything. Only as an example, I don't have the Tata Docomo example. Because of that, I am only giving this as an example. And majority of the litigations are with public sector undertakings, and we will have to see how we will give the confidence to the investing community. Meenakshi Lekhiji has made it very clear that this would improve the, in fact, after the finance bill, this has come, and this would improve the GDP growth rate and many things she spoke.
Ease of doing business,
but in this regard, as majority of the litigation is going to be with the public sector undertakings, though government is taking the major step in setting up this organization, and wherein majority of the appointments were made by the government, but sooner or later they should try to move as far as possible to make it as a totally autonomous body, and this is very much required to make it as a real international hub. And then we can also have our offices in Singapore and London, where we get that business, because as Madam said, even the contract between Indians and Indians, we are preferring to have arbitration center at London or Singapore. So, and we are not able to get good lawyers also because whichever lawyer we are representing, they are telling that he is in London or Singapore. So in the interest of the Indian this thing, we all should have a wonderful international center, and it should be totally autonomous and cost effective. Thank you, Speaker.
Thank you very much.
Please watch Tulsi News.
Please subscribe to Tulsi News.